Hi, and welcome to another video in the series Tech for Everyone, free training in tech provided by T2G.net. If you've got a question about tech, email us at T2G@gmail.com. We promise to answer you. Today's presentation is all about ports. What ports exist on old and new PCs? What devices are connected to these ports? What are they for? Let's see if we can find out. Well, one of the first things we need to know is that we talk about them in terms of input and output ports. Something goes in through this port and something else will come out. You find them in front and behind of any PC. And principally, they're used to connect peripherals like printers, mice, keyboards to PCs. They're many and varied. And one of the things that manufacturers have done to help us along is that they've color-coded some of them just to make life that much easier for us. So let's have a look at some of these things. The first is the PS2 port. As you can see, they're identical. The only real difference, I suppose, is color. The green is for connecting the mouse and the purple is for the keyboard. It's called PS2 not because of the gaming system, but because of the IBM Personal Computer 2, which was introduced in 1987 when these ports made their first appearance. Because they're identical, you do need to be careful when connecting them. You could end up with a mouse connected to a keyboard port and vice versa. Of course, nowadays, most of these devices have been superseded by the USB. We have a parallel port, 25 pins of a dark pin DE shelled port. It's female because we've got these tiny holes here, and is used for connecting older printers. It's highly unlikely that you'd come across a printer nowadays that makes use of this port, but it's nice to know that we know what it is. Older still is the serial port, and one of the first things you'll notice is that we've got these pins sticking out, making it a male port, and believe it or not, it was used for connecting older devices like mice. Again, the USB has taken over. We've got yet another DE shelled port, this time two rows, 15 pins, yellow in color. And that's our MIDI joystick port for connecting MIDI devices, that's a music device, as well as a joystick. When it comes to monitors, we've got a choice. One of the first ports that appeared on the PC was the VGA port. You'll notice that it's three rows of 5 pins, a total of 15 pins in a DE shell. And that's our standard VGA port for connecting our monitor. Once we went digital, the DVI port became available, and you'll notice there are loads of these tiny pins here on this end, and there are many implementations of DVI, so you've got to be careful when buying a monitor that the cable, the DVI cable, is going to match the port on your graphics card or on your PC. When it comes to having both sound and vision coming out of and or going into a port, we've got the HDMI port, the high definition multimedia interface, the only port of the three that you can see that transmits both sound and vision. Talking about audio, we have the 3.5mm tip ring sleeve ports for sound. So, of course, most people will know that when you want to record, you plug in through the pink port. If you want to connect to speakers, you connect to the green port. And if you want to line in an audio device, you do that through the blue. FireWire, because of its high speed, is something that individuals with digital cameras or camcorders would use to transfer these large files. It was developed by Apple and is extremely fast. In fact, the speed ranges from 400 to 800 megabits per second, making it faster than some implementations of USB. As I said, mostly used for digital cameras and camcorders to get that data across as quickly as possible. Now I've got a picture here of a typical laptop, and you can see some of the ports that we've been talking about so far. There's the VGA port there. Over here we've got the HDMI and the FireWire port over here. But we've got a couple more that we need to talk about, so let's continue. Almost every device that you can think of nowadays is networked. And when it comes to an Ethernet port, if you're wired, then you have to use an Ethernet port. It supports an 8-wired cable attached to an RJ45 end. Now, we haven't talked much about that, but we will do in a future video. You'll also notice over here a line port. In fact, if you look at your router, you'll probably see something like this. It's a smaller port, and it supports an RJ11 connector for your phone line. Your phone line cable is much narrower than Ethernet because it's only got 4 wires in there. As I said, lots of devices today make use of Ethernet ports. You're finding them on Blu-ray devices, of course, PCs and switches. Even TVs now are coming with Ethernet ports to connect to the internet. The last port we're going to talk about is, of course, the most universal port and is quite rightly called the Universal Serial Bus port. It's very modern and has replaced many of the ports that we've been talking about in this video. It is talked about in another video, so please check that one out. So, in summary, we've talked about the PS2 port used for the old keyboard and mouse, the parallel port for the printer, the serial port for the oldest of mice, the MIDI joystick port, the audio port, the TRS 3.5mm ports, the FireWire, the Ethernet, and of course the USB. Well, I want to thank you for listening to this presentation for Tech for Everyone. As we've always said, free training is provided by tsquareg.net, and if you've got any questions about tech, email us at tsquareg@gmail.com and we'll answer you. Thank you for listening, and goodbye.